Okay, we've talked about some incredible clubs in this series so far. Clubs with history, clubs where fans come first, clubs that embody the spirit of the game we love. But now, it's time to tell you about a club with perhaps the greatest comeback story of all time. This time, we're in Asturias, Spain, with Real Oviedo, your new favorite club, baby. From the very start, Real Oviedo were doing things differently. Founded on the 26th of March, 1926, the team was born out of a merger with two clubs who had maintained a long sporting rivalry for years in the city, Real Stadium Club Ovetense and Real Club Deportivo Oviedo. Immediately, the club became known for their beautiful one-touch attacking football, a style at least 30 to 40 years ahead of its time, dubbed Delanteras Eléctricas, or the Electric Forwards. Oviedo broke all scoring records, 174 goals in 62 games. But with the outbreak of the Spanish Civil War, fortune started to turn for the club. In 1939, they were forced in the second division with their pitch deemed unplayable after Franco's troops had used it as an ammunition dumping ground. For several decades after, Oviedo would bounce between the first and second tiers, even spending a short stint in the third division. By 1988, they were firmly back in the top flight, playing 13 consecutive seasons in the first division. However, behind the scenes, trouble had been brewing. Oh, trouble, trouble. Behind closed doors, the club's finances were a mess, and after two relegations in quick succession, Oviedo's fragility was exposed. The team was left unable to pay its players, consequently dropping down to the fourth tier. As the club struggled, local government turned their back on them, proclaiming 3rd Division Astur as the city's new team. What the fuck, local government? They even went so far to change Astur's kit to the same colors and alter the badge. Their name was changed to Oviedo AFC, and it looked like the death knell for Real Oviedo. But while the local government did their best to put the final nails in the coffin, Real Oviedo and their fans fought back. United in their hopes to save the team, fans started raising money. It wasn't much, but this effort, that became known as Espíritu 2003, or the Spirit of 2003, ensured that the club survived. The team rallied and clawed their way back to the third tier, but it wasn't to last. By 2006, Alberto González had entered the picture. It's a story we see far too often in football, a false hope whose promises to save a club had allowed him to take a controlling share, and his contribution, 200 grand for a team bus and a serious case of tax evasion. González eventually fled the authorities and left the club in total disarray. A new five-man board took over, with the supporters' voice heard and represented, but the damage at this point was already done. The club's incredible debts loomed once more, and deadlines were set. They needed $1.9 million immediately, $2.5 million to finish the season, and $4 million to secure the club's future. In the spirit of 2003, they turned to their fans once more, offering a share issue at 10 euros and 75 cents a pop. Real Oviedo had faith their supporters would be their salvation, but what followed was an immense and unprecedented response. In 2 weeks, 1.93 million worth of shares were bought by more than 20,000 people in over 70 countries. Fans across the world bought shares. Players former and current bought shares. Even rival clubs, with Real Madrid buying 100,000 worth, which they then ceded to the local council. In fact, even Copa90's staff bought shares. And frankly, they're the reason why we started doing supporters culture documentaries. Instrumental in the success were former club legends that made it their mission to spread the message of the campaign. International superstars like Michu, Juan Mata, and Cazorla had all been given their start at Real Oviedo and seen some of the club's worst times. Nonetheless, through their passion, they were able to rouse a spirit of collective love for football that made fans thousands of miles away from Oviedo do their bit to save the historic club. Luckily, the spirit of support the fans had created was infectious, and it wasn't long before Mexican business magnate Carlos Slim, then the world's richest man, bought 2 million euros of shares himself. With recent headlines dominated by multiple stories of clubs on the brink or in the throes of extinction, Real Oviedo's story stands as a shining example of the role supporters can play, and should play, in securing the club for generations to come. After all the chaos of the past, Real Oviedo can now rest on a single certainty, their majority shareholder, the fans, with a controlling share of 40.81% made up of small shareholders and Oviedistas. We can all rest easy knowing that the Carballones, or Oviedo fans, have their team's best interests at heart. Many will proclaim the story as a miracle, but it's not. It's a testament to what fans are capable of, and a shining example of how a shared love of football can unite us around the world. Since 2015, Real Oviedo have been back in the second tier, and their future looks bright, even if the club doesn't look to be starting any kind of winning tradition anytime soon. The security in La Liga 2 doesn't just mean financial stability, but it also puts them once more in close proximity to their main Asturian rivals, Sporting Gijón. They played their first derby in 14 years in 2018, and trust me when I say, it was incredible. The Asturian derby is set to be played again on March 29th in Gijón, so book your flights and add this one to your football bucket list. The fan support is likely to be incredible, and who knows, after checking them out, Real Oviedo just might become your new favorite club. Thanks for watching, guys, and keep your suggestions coming. This show is all about shining a light on clubs with stories and supporters that deserve to be known to the outside world. So hit us up in the comments, and I'll see you next time on your new favorite club.